prêt à venir au coup d'avoir. Restez placé au sol. Now, as you are listening to this song, you are looking at the greatness of God, how big God is. As you can receive the word, even as you acknowledge the greatness of God in your life, this morning.
To raise up the tribes of Jacob and to restore the the preserve of Israel, or the remnant of Israel, I will also give thee for a light to the Gentiles, that you may be my salvation unto the end of the age. Amen.
Amen.
And in verse 16 of the same chapter, the Bible says, behold, I have graven thee upon the palms of my hands. Thy words are continually before me. May the Lord bless the reading of his word.
Amen.
Amen. Okay, I'm here to share with you a subject that I've entitled, Aligning Myself with My Heavenly Blueprint. Aligning. Putting yourself in line. Aligning myself with my heavenly blueprint.
Inakuzika kwenye meka pale umamba.
Heavenly blueprint. I'll explain what it means.
Amen.
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 Okay, to align means to bring into line.
Kupasa kupuzika kwa wale mtakutilaka yena.
Amen.
Amen.
To align, it means to bring yourself into what? Line. My friend who is currently doing his police training, he knows what it means.
Wamanaisha wa polisi wazo za mission tauza.
Over to my point. You have the right mark. Dress up, shine. You dress up, so you are the same line. Amen. So whoever is not in line, then they have to push themselves. You do with your right or with your left? Okay. So you have to align yourself, everyone of you. If someone comes to look at this, they have to see a straight line. And that is what our brother Petros and our elder have been doing. To make sure that the brick is where? In line. Now, the blueprint means a photographic print of a drawing. Or it is a plan of time. Amen.
Amen.
A blueprint is either a line, a plan or a guide. A blueprint will show you the plan of action. Or it will give you a guide to doing something. A blueprint is the same as the plan that you get whenever you want to start building. So a person who is called an architecture
will
draw a plan. You being the owner of the house, you tell them, I want you to put the bedroom here, what. Then an architecture will interpret what you are saying and put it on paper.
You are never going to want you, but I'm not going to want you to put it on paper.
That paper will be given to the bricklayer. The bricklayer will interpret what is on the paper. Then, whatever step they take, they will be guided by the plan. Hello?
Amen.
So they start setting according to the plan.
Hallelujah. Amen.
I saw it when it's trying to set somewhere. Now we are saying that we need to bring ourselves in line with the plan that God has for us.
Amen.
Many people today, regardless
Amen?
Amen.
Sometimes life has never made sense in their life. Regardless of the status, this has resulted in many people not living up to God's expectation. Until they meet their death.
Hello?
Amen. Sometimes it looks like people understand life, yet they don't. We look like we understand what life is all about. When we don't, the man of God by the name of Miles Monroe, he says whenever you go to the grave, that is where you find people with brilliant ideas have died and never have actualized the idea.
Amen.
Amen. Because they did not know. Hello?
Amen.
So mainly there has been a one-sided interpretation of life by the there is a one-sided interpretation of life. Therefore, this has resulted in the wrong cultures or teaching that have been developed
for blessings.
Amen.
Amen.
However, I am coming to you this morning so that I may remind you that there is a blueprint concerning your life in heaven. The plan for your life is not in the hands of your teacher. The plan of your life is not in the hands of your father.
Make a lot of people who have defined life to you.
you. But there is a blueprint for you in heaven. That you have been engraved in the palms of the hands of God. Amen.
Amen.
So we need to understand God in order to understand our blueprint. When he came to this young man by the name of Jeremiah, he said, young man, I want you to go and preach the word. But the young man says, no, me, I am young. There is no way I am able to carry out this task. This is such a major task. But the Lord said to him, young man, I knew before you were formed in your mother's
womb.
I knew you before you were formed in your mother's
womb.
I have set you apart as a prophet to the nation.
Amen.
In the life of the man by the name of In Genesis. This young man is the 11th son of Jacob. But the Lord begins to show him the blueprint concerning his life in a dream.
In the council of the wicked.
Amen. Amen.
Blessed is the man who does not walk in the counsel of the wicked.
agulidwe na Potifa.
The Bible says when you read,
Bible kama kutipamete
mene, in the book of Genesis,
Tewele wa Genesis,
it says that the favor of God was upon Joseph.
Ikamba kutipu kende ita kwa mungu, kwa zibari wa Joseph.
Now what it is that, whenever you understand the blueprint of God concerning your life, from above.
kwamba
every good and perfect gift comes from above.
Yose mpaksa niposa yaonela icho kwa kwamba.
On the other side, every gift that comes and brings disturbance in your life, it is not coming from God.
Tendeza mbali ina kata kutili yose shita kwaesa muso kwaneza mama yako chumbaso sicho kata kuli mbulu mbuye.
Amen.
Amen.
Are we listening?
Amen.
So the Lord has to push you to your destiny. But you are delaying the Lord to moving in your life. Amen.
Amen.
You are delaying him because of your scant commitment to him. Your scant fellowship with him. Realize the call of God upon their life when they are old.
Whenever I was sitting here, we tell it to a boy,
amen.
Amen.
Because God reveals things to us progressively.
Mungu, ama tumusa kinchupe. Mapamono pamono. Yenda kisogoro pamono pamono.
Amen.
Amen.
He has revealed to you to say, you are going to be great.
Ana atumusa kuli kwa mtu zampambana.
So at every stage, God will speak to you.
He doesn't have a better stage in your sin. We will go anywhere.
Amen.
Amen.
Okay, let's talk about the Genesis 13.
Tell me about what's that? What can I say?
Before we can conclude,
Genesis chapter 13.
Chef, I don't know what is. Amen.
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 It means you just have to withdraw.
Tell me what you're
because
it is an open check. When we say that we see, if you will prosper, you will not lie. But you shall prosper. It's
going
to be credited to you prosperity. So you just have to withdraw. Amen.
Amen.
But when Abraham was given the blueprint, then you get tired of waiting. Amen.
Amen.
The moment you get tired of waiting, you go to another one.
Amen.
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 So Abraham was tired of waiting.
Abraham.
Because God has spoken to him at the age of 75. But this man at this time now is almost
90 something.
Then it is not fulfilled in his life. When you understand the blueprint of God concerning your life, you continue waiting upon the Lord. Because the Bible says, but they that wait upon the Lord, amen, they shall run and not grow weary. They shall walk and not faint.
So they end as a
man up their wings like eagles. They will not get tired. Because they are waiting upon the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Shall we stand? So child of God, you ought to wait upon the Lord. Don't behave like Abraham. You begin to complain. Because you can't see things working for you.
Isaiah,
he understood.
Understood.
He said, "Here, O Israel,
I am
the servant of God. You can go out of your house and say, 'Here, O Israel, I am the servant of God.' Before I formed in my mother's womb, the Lord had called me. I have preached to you. I am the servant of God." Isaiah understood.
Amen.
He understood who he was. He understood that God had engraved him in the palms of his
hand.
Amen. These are engraved. No matter what I do, I can't erase them.
Amen.
Amen. So in the same way,
Zed
has engraved us like this. Just do like this. You able to see those lines, eh? Hello? Are you able to see them? So the same way that you are seeing those engravings in your hands, that is the same way God has engraved you. So there is no trust there in the palms of God.
Amen.
There is the person God you is just there.
Amen.
In the palms of God.
Amen.
Amen. There is a person called Mary in the palms of God. So he's looking at that right now. And
what's
the not moving according to what is in the hands is very much surprised. Therefore, the only way you are able to understand your blueprint in heaven is when you stay in the house of God all times. Amen.
Amen.
Remain in the house of God. In the secret place of the Most High.
Amen.
If you stay in the house of God, then God will activate His plan for your life. Then you download that which God has for you in life. When these guys are marching, my friend, they will continue going forward. As long as they don't ask them to turn to the left or to the right, so don't be disobedient. Listen to what God is telling you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Listen to what God is telling you through His servant. And through the word.
Amen.
Amen. I want you to lift up your hand. Come on, listen.
I'm gonna make it. Abraham.
But when the Lord added himself to him, everything around him began to develop.
So that's
and it became conducive to the fulfillment of the plan. So there is need to faith the plan of God in your life. If you are that one child of God, I want you to run the plan quickly. You run to a
miracle.
In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus.
Your name is Jehovah. Your name is Elohim. At the mention of your name, every knee must bow. At the mention of your name, every tongue shall confess.
one was new, over here. The Lord wants to ignite that, wants to rekindle the fire in you. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. So there is fire that is coming upon your life. Just to rekindle that which is in your life right now. Just to rekindle that fire. For God to bring. So that it is actualized in your life. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jehovah. You are being redeemed right now. You are being redeemed right now. Jesus, in the name of Jesus.